Servus Freunde, my name is Jimmy Cage and Zodu Kavum is a 2013 Tamil language crime comedy. It was the first film by director and writer Nalan Kumarasamy and it stars Vijay Sethupathi, Bobby Simha, Ashok Selvan, Ramesh Tilak, Karuna Karan, Sanchita Shetty, Yog Juppy and some more. According to Wikipedia, the title Zodu Kavum translates to Karma will get you back, but it's also known under the English titles Evil Engulfs and Deception is Addictive. And honestly, all of them fit really well. It's a really funny dark comedy about four petty criminals who are kidnapping the son of the one honest politician there is. His son, though, is not that honest himself and actually wanted to get kidnapped to get money out of his father. There are a lot of smaller and bigger twists and turns that I of course don't want to lay out in detail for you, and overall there's just a lot of craziness happening. But it's mostly not completely over the top, but rather clever, very well written, kind of deadpan, and the characters all have their own little backstories and quirks. I especially liked how our little group of petty criminals is coming together and how their whole operation is taking shape. The story takes place in Chennai and I think it's quite relatable how these guys don't really know what they should do with themselves. At first, at least some of them still have regular jobs, but it's definitely not fulfilling and just hanging around and boozing seems to be a more than good enough alternative. From the get-go there's a fun banter between them. But things really start to evolve once Kesavan, Sekar and Pagalavan meet a slightly older Das, played by Vijay Sethupathi. But before they do, we the audience already have, and his introduction is pretty great. It establishes the main thing of the movie, which is kidnapping, and it's also kind of exemplary for the film's fun style. At first, one might mistake Das for this cool hero kind of guy, casually smoking and accompanied by this gorgeous looking young woman played by Sanchita Shetty. But the girl he tried to kidnap doesn't take a shit for a second, and she's not even running away, but attacking him from outside the car, with him panicking and looking like a complete fool. All while Sanchita Shetty's character doesn't pay any attention to it and just continues to eat her ice cream. Vijay Sethupathi's acting is wonderful here and will be in the rest of the movie. He has come up with these great rules about kidnapping that should guarantee that nothing bad is happening, neither to the victims nor to him and his team. Of course, they will break those rules and things will go wrong. But how those rules are introduced in the first place and, in general, the way the dialogue was written and is delivered is adding a lot to the film's comedy. Very often it's how people address or react to a certain situation. For example, in this big brawl in a bar when all of a sudden the police is arriving. Someone is asking them, almost accusing, if they don't announce their arrival with sirens anymore. But that little introduction scene of Vijay Sethupathi also demonstrates the film's really crisp editing that's so often used for comedic effect. The surprise of seeing that kidnapped girl all of a sudden standing outside the car and hitting him. In the second half, once our protagonists have brought themselves in a very dire situation, the movie introduces the brutal, ruthless police inspector Brahma, played by Yog Juppy, who by the way doesn't utter a single word through the whole film. He only beats up or downright shoots people, of course not according to the law. There's this fantastic little montage of him messing up all those criminals, and again, the editing by Leo John Paul is fantastic. It creates such a great flow, but it's also really funny, especially combined with the real nice cinematography by Dinesh Krishnan. Another crucial element for the film's original style is the rather unconventional music that was composed by Santosh Narayanan. It puts a strong driving force behind the images, and it has this fun, ironic feel. Probably the best song of the film, Kom Na Kom, with lyrics by Ganesh Kumar B, is playing in another great montage scene that shows us our group performing all of their small-time kidnappings, which again is presented in a really clever and comedic way. There's only one real song and dance number, Kasu Panam, with lyrics by Gana Bala, shortly after the interval, which is really just a music video and could be taken out of the movie completely. But because it's more or less directly in the middle of the movie, it features some nice dancing and set design, and the lyrics are all about money, I didn't really mind it that much because it felt like this nice halftime show before the actual story continues. And how that story is told and how it keeps changing is equally engaging and fun. Though I have to say that it gets a bit bloated in the second half, and not all of its turns and ideas and how the themes of honesty, corruption and crime are intertwined fully work in the end. The overall pacing is good, but it could have been a little bit faster, and I thought its momentum isn't completely carrying it over the finish line. I also thought the role of Sanchita Shetty should have been expanded. It's also a bit problematic in some regards, but I can excuse that. I only wished more would have come out of it, or rather more about Das' state of mind and what he might do. So, in German I'd say, mit Sodu Kavum hat Nalan Kumarasamy ein starkes Debütwerk abgeliefert. Eine wirklich witzige, toll geschriebene, gut inszenierte und blendend gespielte Gangsterkomödie, die nur in der zweiten Hälfte hier und da vielleicht etwas zu viel will. I give Sodu Kavum 7 out of 10. It's more like 7.3, but I don't do that. Alright, that's it. Like always, comment below and let me know what you think about Sodu Kavum. You can hit me up on Twitter, Instagram and Letterboxd and also on Patreon, simply at The Jimmy Cage. You can also become a member of the channel and get exclusive rewards. And if you enjoyed this episode, please give me a thumbs up, share, subscribe, whatever you like. And make sure you hit that bell for all I have to tell.